Hi everyone, it's Catherine and welcome back to my channel. I feel like I have to explain myself. I haven't posted in like 2 or 3 months and there's a very good reason for that, or just lots of good reasons for that. It's just been, everything's been shit lately. That's the short version. I got sick like in February, did not want to do anything. I was sick for like 2 weeks. And then my roommate got sick, and my boyfriend, who we all like live together, also got sick. And then I got sick again with like this just terrible cold. I don't even know what it was. Took forever to recover. Probably took another like week and a half. So I was sick twice in the same like span of a month. And then I got my wisdom teeth out. But I'm back. I'm making my great YouTube return and I'm very excited because I'm going to a concert tonight. So this is actually a get ready with me video. So we're actually going to Sabrina. Me and one of my close friends, we're going together. And I swear to God, have never been to a concert in my entire life. Ever been anywhere. So I'm so excited. It's Sabrina Carpenter and we have floor seats. I can't wait. So I'm not showing you my room because it's a fucking mess. See, this is what I'm dealing with right now. I haven't put any of my clothes away in like 2 weeks. So, yeah. Stuff that I have to deal with tomorrow or sometime this week. But not today, because today is for going out and having a good time. Even though I never go out and my idea of going out is literally staying home. I really wanted to make Taylor Swift my first concert. That was my goal this year, and I was really sad when I didn't get tickets. I was just like, you know what? Taylor Swift is great. I'm definitely like a hardcore Swiftie, but Sabrina Carpenter is a good close second, so I'm not even mad about it. Okay. Gonna set you guys up right there. Ah, put on my makeup mirror. I feel like I look like a mess, and I don't want to look like this on YouTube, but this is like reality of what people look like every day, so I shouldn't even like be embarrassed. I'm just gonna like, I don't know how people do these videos of them talking through doing their makeup because I feel like I have to be so focused doing my makeup. Truly wish I were like one of those girlies who was obsessed and knows the name of every single product and knows how to use it, but I just am not. I'm a book girly, I'm a nerd. So next I'm gonna do my blush and highlighter because this is my very unconventional way of doing makeup, but I don't put on foundation or primer, which might sound so weird. I also don't contour. I don't do like any of that, mainly because I don't know how, but also because I feel like my skin, like quality of skin is better without it sometimes, to be honest. I usually just put blush directly on my face, which I don't know if that's a good thing or not. I'm probably not gonna stop doing it this way. This is the way I've been doing it since I was like a teen and had no like basis for how to put on makeup. Go in here kind of low. Oops, might have gone too low. That was for sure way too blush. Hold on, we're gonna take round two on this. So I do blush down here. I also have really liked, I saw another YouTuber doing it, but you put blush kind of like on the side of your nose, right here. And I don't know if that's weird or not, or like not acceptable to do, but I think it just, I really like having like rosy cheeks. And so I think that that's just my personal preference. So I do that a lot. And then I'm going with the bigger brush. Let's see. Ow, just pumped myself in the eye. Next I'm gonna do highlighter. This is honestly all I do for my like face, I guess. I sometimes do eyeshadow, but I'm not super good at it either. Still haven't mastered that, so I mainly stick to these things and then like mascara. And then highlighter, I just put kind of on my cheekbones, or I try to. And then like down my nose, skip a little bit, go to the edge of my nose, and then I might go back in, and I like to do it kind of like above the brow and just below it on the side because I think it just kind of like accentuates where I want the sun to hit my face and just make it look glowy. So that's what I do. Then go in with this big brush again. Kind of blend it out. Kind of deciding if I want to wear eyeliner tonight or not. I feel like because it's Sabrina Carpenter, I should. Also, I like the fact that I'm going to Sabrina Carpenter when I've just gotten bangs. I haven't had bangs since I was like a child. I used to have them. My parents put me on bangs, like they put me on drugs or something. They gave me bangs because I have a genetic condition
that basically gives me bald spots on the side of my head. Usually my hair covers it, so they're not really like noticeable. Like maybe you can tell in this video, but I really don't feel like they're noticeable in public. So they gave me bangs for like most of my life. I had them, and then I decided when I was like nearing adulthood that I just really wanted to grow them out. I feel like they looked too little kiddish. Even though it's been like really crappy the past 2 months, I've just been dealing with a bunch of shit. My reading pace has never been better, guys. And I don't know if it's just all the stress that I've been going through that really, I just need some kind of escapism throughout my week. I've been reading so much, and like, I don't think I've ever had a reading year this good since I was like young and a teenager. But I went through 13 books so far I'm on my 14th read right now. My goal right now was to be at 15, and so I'm only 2 books behind, so it's really easy for me to be able to catch up and meet that. So I am feeling motivated and just really excited. I also feel like the quality of books that I've read this year has just been really high. Like, they've been some of my favorite all-time books so far, so just really excited to keep up the momentum and just share those with you guys. My next video, for sure, I've been planning forever, is gonna be a reading wrap-up for the months of January through March, basically, and that video will have 13 books in it, probably 10 of which I'm gonna recommend that you guys read. So look forward to that, because I'll have some recommendations for you guys. And yeah, I'm just really excited. Started January off really good. I got into my Taylor Jenkins read era. So I read kind of the main books that are always advertised on BookTok and that I've seen people post about. I think, what did I start with? I started with Malibu Rising. Kind of wanted to ease myself into it. It was so good, so much better than I expected it to be honest. And my favorite thing about her books have just been that they're not like romance plots, which is basically all I read if you know anything remotely about me. And they're just so different than what I'm used to reading that it's like really refreshing and also like a lot more practically applicable to my life, just in terms of like overcoming family generational trauma. And I mean, the main kind of plot of that book revolves around a divorced couple and how their divorce impacts the children, and then how the children, it's like a family of 5, and they're all surfers, like super famous surfers, and they're also famous in their own ways. And it's just about how they work to overcome, you know, what their parents went through, and also not repeat cycles. So like breaking all these cycles of abuse that they had to endure as children and watching their parents. And it goes kind of back and forth between the story of the parents and the children, who are now like grown and pretty old adults. So it's really interesting. It was a really interesting read. I can't wait to talk more about it in my review. But yeah, I started off really strong with that book. And then I picked up The 7 Husbands of Evelyn Hugo. Oh my god, so good, so good. This also really inspired me to want to shoot a movies as book recommendations, because I feel like so many of the books that I've read remind me of movies that I've recently been watching as well. And so I don't want to spoil it because I don't want to say what that book reminds me of, but I look forward to that too because I'm really excited to film that. And yeah, I don't know. My favorite probably has to be Daisy Jones and the Six, though. And if you follow me on Instagram, you've seen me post nonstop about it. Literally got bangs inspired by Daisy Jones. So I don't know if that's any indication of how much that story has become my entire personality in life. But yeah, that's basically what's happened. So yeah, such a good book. I love the characters so much and their complexity and just like the fact that there's romance in it, but it's not like the main plot. Like, I feel like a lot of books have like talk about having a romance subplot, but they don't actually, and romance is the main plot. But this one actually has a romance subplot, and just the story of like the obstacles that they face as a band, like this family dynamic, I think is really interesting and something I've never read before. And I just think it's really cool. It really captures the times of like the 70s too, trying to get into music. The show came out like right around the time when I read it, which I had no idea. But if you haven't watched it, and you don't even have to be a reader to watch it. Like, that's the biggest thing, is that the show is so good. I literally watched it with my boyfriend, and I was so happy because we were able to, like, talk about it together and talk about the character dynamics and stuff, which is so interesting when you're talking to someone who hasn't read the book. And so I was able to, like, explain all the details and context. And then the actors, top tier. Everything about the show, casting, like plot line, even the details that they left out of the book, honestly, I didn't mind it at all because I feel like I didn't take anything away from the interactions that were happening in the show. And so I was just really happy with how it turned out. The main, like, guy of the band is played by Sam Claflin. Yes, Sam Claflin, which is the same guy who plays Finnick in The Hunger Games, if you didn't know. And then the main actress who I was extremely excited about, her name is Riley Keough. I can never pronounce her last name. And she's either the great-granddaughter or great-great-granddaughter, I think, of Elvis Presley. And so she sings in the show, which is so cool to see because you see her playing this character that is so similar to who her grandfather was, and you can see like so many similarities come out in her character when she plays it. And so I think that's just really cool. It's on Amazon Prime and it's only 10 episodes, so super manageable to watch. I think I watched it as it was coming out, so there were like 2 or 3 episodes a week and it was pretty bingeable. So
obsessed. This is the final look with the curls in. Now I am going to pick out an outfit to wear. And yeah, no idea what I'm wearing. I have a few options. I was originally planning on wearing a tube top, black leather pants, and then I have a blazer that can go with it from Zara. But I feel like this is not color matching, so I'm kind of scared. I don't know if it's gonna match right or look right. I also have this shirt, which is really cute floral pattern. The kind of vibe I'm going for is more like hopeless romantic because I feel like that's what most people wear to her concert. And so I could wear that with black pants and then maybe a black leather jacket potentially. I also have this gold shirt over here with sleeves on it. And then I also have this cute shirt. It's kind of see-through though. And then I also have pink pants. And so I really need help. I don't know what to wear. I might post some Instagram polls or something on TikTok and just see what y'all think. Okay, so I just finished getting ready and I added a black bow in my hair because I feel like that's just very Sabrina-like. And I added my lipstick on finally. And so this is the final fit. Ignore my tan lines. I got super sunburned last weekend. But I'm wearing the pink tube top from the first option. I'm just not gonna wear the blazer because I feel like it's gonna be too hot for that anyways. But I think I would just really regret it if I didn't wear pink to a Sabrina Carpenter concert because like pink is her color, you know, like there's no other option. So I'm wearing the pink tube top, leather pants, and then I have like these white boots. And they're really cute and they just complete the outfit really well.
I'm just waiting for my friend to pick me up and we're gonna head to the concert.
Years and moments of my life, and the only reason that it feels safe is because every person in this room feels like love and just really, really good energy. And there's something so pure about people that come to concerts. I think like music lovers are just like, you're just looking for love and you're just looking for acceptance and you're just looking to like, I'm at a concert, I'm just in my own head and I learned so much about myself. And so I hope you can feel that way tonight, that you can get a little bit closer to yourself, and maybe one of these rants that I go on will spark something in you.
Thank you.
have Yubo? Yeah! This is already the best story ever.
Okay, so it's basically like Tinder for teens, right? It's like quarantine, right? It's like 2020.
Wait, what do you mean it was popular during quarantine? You all were trying to meet up during quarantine? On Tinder for teens? I'm not trying to expose you, by the way. I'm just trolling. It's okay. So you guys haven't even met up yet? Oh girl, okay, wait, skip to the part where you meet up, and is it good or bad?
So we had a meeting, we had FaceTime before this, so I knew I wasn't getting kidnapped, okay? We finally met in person, and as you were saying, there's nothing to do in Sacramento. We literally went to Target and Dutch Bros.
Dutch Bros. I feel like this is going somewhere bad. I'm sure in the moment it felt super like not like that, but the way Dutch Bros parking lot is sus. So other girl messages you. Yeah, no, I think he knew for sure. I think even the tires would have been fine.
Okay, happy ending. Flash forward. I'm here with my boyfriend right now.
Oh! Wait, see? There's hope. Oh my god. Hi, what's your name? What's your name? Ian, everyone say we love you, Ian.
Love you, Ian.
So, you're happy now. But I wanna channel how you felt when it happened to you. So I'm gonna sing this song because I think it actually fits pretty well. And this is what I like to Andrew, I like to dedicate this song to you and this insane fucking story you just told me. And I'm so sorry. I also have never heard of Tinder for tweens, so that was a new discovery for me. Sing along to your own song.
Bust the windows out your car. I'm dead as hell, it's too hard.
happens is because you guys come, and I don't want you to forget that. You're just really cool, and I need to how grateful I am for you. There was a song, also my nails chipped, and I just realized that. And like, if anyone saw that, yeah, no, but just please don't like zoom in. Just, you can't, it's so late in the show also. I should have said this like way in the beginning, but delete all your videos if my nails look bad. No, I was gonna say, before I put out emails I can't send, I felt a lot of things. I felt fear, I felt excitement, and I felt really grateful that I could just be honest and kind of get that weight off of my shoulders after a really long time. And there was a song in particular that I was really scared to release, and so I kind of tucked it at the very, very, very end of the album. And I put it on Instagram first before I released it, because I was like, maybe we just test the waters and maybe we see if this is a really bad idea. And it was like the opposite. Like, I've never felt more seen and accepted and understood after writing a song that I felt maybe nobody would relate to. And this song means a lot to me. It's really about acceptance, and it's taken me a long time to get there, and every day I still struggle. Sometimes I take a couple steps back, and other days I take a few steps forward, but every time I listen to this song, it kind of grounds me and brings me back. It's called Decode.
Nonsense by Sabrina Carpenter.
I don't even know what that means.
No one knows what it means, but it's provocative.
No, it's not.
It gets the people going.
Yeah.
TikTok. Wasn't that joke funny, Sacramento? Nope. I do think what's so funny about this show is I feel like I've grown up with some of you, and some of you I'm just meeting now. It has been a wild ride to see familiar faces in the crowd, and I see a lot of new faces in the crowd. And then, you know, I started when I was a wee little girl, and I wasn't even allowed to say I'm a slut back then, so we've come a long way, and I've come to this casino in the middle of nowhere, so I'm gonna play with you guys all night. Hard Rock, thanks for having us. This song's called Because I Like the Lord.
I said I wanted finished, and you said you knew a guy. You showed up with a bookmark, and smiled in your eyes. Put a cuddle in a trampoline. You're being so reckless. You're bawling over black IDs and complicated accents. I fell so deeply in the rain.